no, it worked. Hello, people's Abingewebs. It's the Lunatic back again, and welcome to my humble abode. Yes, this is where I come to relax after a long day of mining and crafting and enslaving the blockheaded populations of this world. But we're not really here to talk about me, so let's move on to... Wait, what? You're here to talk about me? Why wasn't I told? 100th video vlog? What? Really? Are you sure? I'm supposed to answer questions? Oh boy. Well, that's not really a question, but I'm a person. Oh, certainly, and thank you for asking this time. I make YouTube videos. I am 1,000,003 years old. The frozen tundra of the upper Midwest. See also Arctic Circle 2.0. Usually, except when it's part of Canada or it doesn't exist. Yeah. Well, because I grew up reading awesome British books and everybody in it had European accents of various and sundry kinds, and they kinda stuck with me to a degree, so yeah. Surprisingly, they're people too. Oh, fine, you're so boring. Okay. I'm the oldest of 9 kids. 6 boys, 3 girls. I also have parents, along with various and sundry aunts, uncles, grandparents, cousins. I have a sister-in-law, a nephew, various friends that I've adopted, and now they're stuck with me as their older brother forever. Oh, what kind of a question is that? Of course I want to keep answering these boring, dull questions. No, I was being sarcastic. Can we please skip to the ones that other people ask that are actually interesting? Well, 98% of my game time is honestly spent on Minecraft, as you can see. But I also do sometimes play Assassin's Creed, Thomas Was Alone, Team Fortress 2, Portal, FTL Faster Than Light, Submachine, Shadow of the Colossus, GTA 5, Connect 4, Tic-Tac-Toe, and the occasional bout of chess. Question to ask, because I have many friends who are girls, so I'm not ever sure if I should say that yes, I do have many girlfriends, or if you're actually asking if I'm dating, and answering like that would get me killed. That all people are treated equally, but I am just a little more equal than the rest. See previous answer. Just hanging loose, bruh. Never doing that again. Ever. That was... You're lucky there, Thunder. That was for you. I love sharing my more creative moments with people and interacting with those who have commented on my videos and watched them and things like that. It's a lot of fun to have that sort of community and just talk to other people about the stuff that I'm doing. I love building Lego, playing instruments, doing judo, writing, many other things. Really, I have way too many hobbies. Way too many hobbies, so I never do any of them. you're gonna make me choose? No, I can't do that. No, there's just too many awesome foods out there. Too many awesome foods. Sorry, I can't do it. No, actually, I do have a favorite food. I just thought of this. It's corn on the cob. Nothing on earth beats a properly done, good, fresh, grilled corn on the cob with some butter, pepper. Oh, goodness. How much longer is this going to last? I have corn on the cob I need to make. Yeah, go right ahead, sure. To be perfectly honest, it's Minecraft. This is actually a common misconception. The square root of pineapple is actually fir cone. You see, what happened was, the misconception came about when the first smoothie empire opened back in the early 1600s, and the original smoothie recipe had that perfect equation in it for the recipe, but one of the smoothie smiths, the master smoothie smiths that was working there, accidentally spilled some smoothie, smudging the equation, making it look like it was actually a raspberry. So that was actually the main copy that was used when the king at the time of Slovakia or wherever, no, what was it, of Canterbury? Something like that, wherever it was, this king duty ordered all of these recipes to be handed out to the people so that they could also make their own smoothies and it wouldn't be a complete monopoly by the smoothie empire. So that was copied from there, and unfortunately the smudged recipe was included in the final copy. So that's where the misconception comes from, but pineapple is actually square rooted by fir cone. Yes, fir cone. I started YouTube because I enjoyed watching these videos that I had found of people playing video games and, you know, doing vlogs and whatnot, and I wanted to get in on it, and it looked like they were having fun, and I thought, hey, why not? If it's gonna be something that's fun, I'll do it too. And maybe, you know, I thought maybe somebody would find some enjoyment from it. As for my plans for the future, to quote the Joker, do I really look like a guy with a plan? No, really. I don't really have any specific plans, but I do plan on making more videos, hopefully getting more content out, and starting a couple of series hopefully soon. But life is busy, and I don't have time to do the things I would like. But my plans are to do more things. That's my plans. Misconception. I am not actually a carrot. I am called a carrot when I'm colored confused. Well, since I'm antisocial and insecure, that would make it zero. I have a great many favorite YouTubers, and to pick a favorite, or even a few favorites out of a lot of them, would honestly be doing a disservice to the others. But I have a couple of special mentions to give out. That would be Tango Tech and Impulse SV. The two of them have been a huge inspiration to me, and you should really go check them out. Links are going to be down in the description for them. They've inspired me with my building style in Minecraft. They've inspired me in just the things that I want to do and get into, and they're a lot of fun, great guys. Really, seriously, go check them out if you haven't already. And they actually asked me a couple of questions for this as well, so we're going to get to those now.
Why do you consider yourself a lunatic? What is it about you that you consider to be loony? That's my question.
That's a good question.
There you go.
No reason, really. I don't even like moons. Don't collect them or anything. Just, there's really no reason that I consider myself to be particularly loony. In case you didn't know, these are what loons look like. Yes.
Let's see.
Now you gotta come up with something.
What
better.
if it's your 100th video, I would probably ask you... admittedly, I haven't seen your videos, so I don't know from personal experience, but I would ask you, what is your favorite video that you made and why?
Good.
And what kind of things do you like about that video that you feel separated as a high-quality video? That's a decent question.
Very, very, very good question.
Liked it.
Okay. So really there's three. In no particular order here. We have the herbivorous hat. It was a ton of fun to plan that one. I felt the idea behind it was wonderful. It was one of my very few actually planned out things that I've ever done. And it was so much fun to edit, so much fun to record, so much fun to actually, you know, record the first shot where I sit in and the hat gets pulled down over my head. And then literally it was 2 days later that I went and I got a haircut, came straight back home, recorded the next scene, and then left for work. Lots of fun there, great time. And I feel like the quality of that episode is one of the greatest ones that I have. Another one is the spicy chicken vlog. It's one of the earlier videos that I've done, the first vlog that you'll see on my channel. It's actually, I think, like the fifth video that you'll see on my channel. Number 5. Out of 99, or actually 100 with this video, and it was just a ton of fun to get together with my friends and record some silly, you know, fun times with that. The editing was fun, the idea behind it once again was kind of silly and great, and we just had a splendid time with it. So those are my favorite episodes, and it stood out because it was brilliant. It was so much fun to do. The third one is honestly this video here. You know, I was writing the script last night, and I was like, you know, this is a ton of fun. I haven't released this yet, but this video has been great to put together. The questions are awesome. I'm sure I'm going to have a fun time editing it. I haven't done so now. But it's just going to be a great video, you know. Hopefully everything will turn out well. I have this green screen here, which you never know how those are going to work. The lighting isn't the best, so that'll be fun. That'll probably be a green glow around me the entire time, but it's still going to be a great video. Hopefully the quality will be good enough to at least use, but yeah, and it's so much fun. So those are probably my three top videos there that I have made so far. Always, if you ever want to ask me any questions, you know, drop a comment in the comment section, I guess. Shoot me a message on my Lunatic Facebook page. I'm on Twitter. That's it, probably. Yeah, just, you know, get a hold of me some way. Ask me a question. I'll either answer you directly. I love interacting with the community. So that's, you know, one of my favorite things to do is talk to you guys. So I'll answer you directly, or if it's a good enough question, maybe it'll be in another video. Who knows? There could be a 200th video special coming along at some point where I might do another Q&A. Who knows? That one will, of course, include explosions and fireworks around me. Yep, totally doing that. So yeah, this was a lot of fun, but I gotta get going now. Things to do, stuff and things to see, stuff and things to people, something like that. You know what I'm trying to say. Here's to another 100 videos, but for now, ta-ra, peoples of interwebs, and I'll see you next time.
In case you didn't know, these are what loons look like. Yes. Here, check them out. That could have ended very badly. My camera wonky.